Hi, this is Greg and Anthony at Mind's Eye Graphics. We're going to do some video on our reclaim loop, and Anthony's going to do a demonstration with ink removal using Soddy IR18. A couple of squirts, a damp brush, and he's going to remove all of the remaining ink. We pulled the tape out, we've scraped all the good ink out, and this is just the residual ink. Work both sides. If you've had any ink bypass, make sure you get the globs and the goo out. Then we take a garden hose and rinse it out on the flat table. Flat table tilts to the back, has a drain, which goes into our settling tank. Then he puts that in a pile. Typically, we'll do anywhere from 8 to 16 screens in the pile. Then he's going to wait a minute while I talk. We take the screen that has been on our drag out drip back rack, and he takes it and puts it in the sink. That eliminates one of the big problems with dip tanks, which is pulling out a lot of product every time you take a screen out. So he's going to pull the screen that's been in there the longest. And that's on an angle, and as I come back up here and go in close, you can see where all of that product is dripping right back into the tank. We only lose less than an ounce of product mixed with water on every screen we pull out. Now that dip tank is a 37-gallon dip tank that's got four screens in it. You can do one, two, three, or four depending on the emulsion and the concentration of this chemical, but we find this rotation works very well. The tank of 37 gallons is initially charged with 10 ounces of ER2, and then every morning before we start, we add 2 more ounces of ER2 to make the chemical a little stronger. Sort of like when you open a 2-liter bottle of pop, after a couple of days the fizz is gone, the reactivity of the tank goes down with time. So Anthony's now going to take and use the pressure washer. And this is a screen that has been soaking for 6 to 8 minutes. And now he's applying a little more IR18 to get rid of the remaining ink and any haze. If you do this correctly, you never have to worry about haze removers. He's also going to clean the rollers to make sure that we don't get ink where we don't want it. Now, as you notice, the emulsion was still all in place in the mesh when he was using the pressure washer. You don't want to take too much off in the dip tank, because all of that emulsion going to the bottom of the dip tank creates a sludge which makes a mess. It also uses up the reactivity of the emulsion remover, so we want all of that emulsion going down the drain into our settling tank. We have a preliminary settling tank right underneath the first sink, going into a secondary settling tank underneath the flat table, and then that, after it's had a chance to let all of the solids flow out, goes into the drain. At that point, it's clear liquid that's going down the drain. Once or twice a year, we take 30 or 40 gallons of sludge out of those settling tanks that is not going into our PVC pipes. Now Anthony's going to do the pressure washing and the final rinse. Then he's going to take the garden hose at city water pressure and go through and sheet, make sure he's got good, clean screen, no fish eyes, no emulsion or chemical residue. And if he's happy the way it sheets off, he then takes it, puts it into an old washout sink that we've converted into a drying rack. And that drying rack actually has a couple of box fans across the top. If you want to, you can throw furnace filters on top of them to keep the air clean. But it is allowing, in our situation, 34 screens to be completely dry. And then when they're done, they go into our screen room for coating. And that's how we reclaim screens at Mind's Eye Graphics. Average throughput, when you're not in a hurry, is about 20 to 22 screens per hour. If you want to put a second person on doing the ink removal, you can get up to 30 to 35 real easy. Take care. Thanks. Bye.